Straight talk. If we were kings and queens, what happened? How can you use this true knowledge or history today?
Unyana wenkosi uba likobora ukuba akaziwa. Yene gestitati logically twayekie baria yinohali. Zanakalaim ni mpanjaga lasa andevraha ti fantatra. Inyane enkosi iba isigila lapo ingazwa khona. Mwana wa falme anakuwa mtumwa ikiwa haijulikani. Mwana washe mranda kumwe. Nwa eze buru ohuma oburu na amaria. We were indeed kings and queens, but we have fallen on very hard times. Why? And how can we restore ourselves again? Totems are only for those who descended from kings and a queen. There is no African descendant who is totemless. Are your totems activated? To learn more and activate your true identity, you need totems. Send us an email on join@marifado.com if you want to learn more about this. The following article is taken from the book UNESCO General History of Africa, Volume 2, Ancient Civilizations of Africa, The Egyptians as They Saw Themselves. It is no waste of time to get the views of those principally concerned. How did the ancient Egyptians see themselves? Into which ethnic category did they put themselves under? What did they call themselves? The language and literature left to us by the Egyptians of the Pharaonic epoch supply explicit answers to these questions, which the scholars cannot refrain from minimizing, twisting, and interpreting. The Egyptians had only one term to designate themselves, KMT Hamit, shown here, the Negroes, literally, or the Blacks, literally. This is the popular and only strongest term existing in the Pharaonic tongue to indicate darkness or blackness or melanin. The word is the etymological origin of the well-known root Hamit, which has proliferated in modern anthropological literature. The biblical root Kam or Ham is probably derived from it, and it has therefore been necessary to distort the facts to enable this root today to mean white in Egyptological terms, whereas in the Pharaonic mother tongue, which gave it birth, it meant black. To never be cheated by these people again. It is a remarkable circumstance that the ancient Egyptians should never have had the idea of applying these qualifications to the Nubians and other populations of Africa to distinguish them from themselves. The Egyptians used the expression Nahas to designate the Nubians, and the Nahas is the name of a people with no color connotation in Egyptian. It is a deliberate mistranslation to render it as Negro, as is done in almost all present day publications. Let's continue with our exposure. The ancient Egyptians called their pharaohs Neja. Egyptian's pharaoh was seen as a representation of the sun principle, the sun divinity, so-called god now. The original pharaoh, who were pure melanin-dominant humans, so-called Africans, saw black skin as sacred and direct blessing from the sun god Aten or Adona, where you get your word Adonai. In fact, blackness and black skin became associated with the god and the sun. Black people were powerful, culturally advanced, militarily superior, black, dark brown in complexion, strong stature, tall and described as handsome, and a handsome race in totality. Even Herodotus wrote that, the Greek historian, in his book The History's Description of Ethiopians of Africa and South India. The recognition of the pharaoh as a living god
and the black skin as a blessing spread worldwide to other cultures. Of course, that was the source of the jealousy that we see today. There it is obvious. Therefore, meaning that the white Arabs, the Europeans, and many, many others who are not melanin recessive are not descendants of ancient Egyptians. Because if they were, they wouldn't abuse our kings like this. Namburamasase, or so-called Ramses II, is most famous for the exile of white people out of Egypt. Because of this reason, the notoriously racist Napoleon Bonaparte, during his raid on the graveyards of our Egyptian ancestors, destroyed so much, including shooting the nose and lips off the Sphinx with cannons. This is also the true meaning behind this statue of Champollion, Napoleon's right-hand man, so-called father of Egyptology, having his foot on the statue of Pharaoh Ramses II. This must be stopped. This must be destroyed. This statue must be removed and destroyed. It's one of the statues that must fall. Osiris, the perfect black. So when they come and tell you that Osiris was European and they paint themselves as Osiris, they are lying. The ancient Egyptians were black. The ancient Egyptians were melanin-dominant humans. The ancient Egyptians came from the south. They came from the Great Lakes. They are us. It's us. We are part of those people. Europeans are not. The current people in Middle East were not there. They were not even anywhere near Africa. They are invaders. They are colonists. All the people are Sisi, all of them, right from Morocco across, right to Iraq. They were not there. They are colonists. They came from Europe. In fact, Negja became the Ethiopian, or Negja, this is from Retake Your Fame, a black contribution to world civilization revised in, by Alma von Fleischer. In what manner the word for God, Ngu, Negja, 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 became Nigger, or Nigger, or Negro, or Niger. Who corrupted the term? We'll soon find out. The term Nigger was used by the ancient Romans to describe the skin color of the people known to them as Ethiope Maures. Nigger is founded on that. It's a product of institutional slavery. It's the basic logic of slavery to justify the atrocities of melanin-dominant humans. We must teach our youth that the N-word is intolerable and unacceptable. We are giving our children an erroneous assumption by encouraging the use of these dehumanizing, offensive, and abusive words. Nigger, negro, a sung and repeated by comedians and ignorant musicians. These words do not equal Ngu, Negas, Naga, Gus, Nguzo, Ngami, Nkos, and Ngoma, words of rulership, principles, and power. Negas or Negus is Amharic and Ethiopic for king, for ruler, as well as to rule. The one who dances in the shadows is you and me. The Dagon god serpent and the Kamata ancient Kamiti serpents are identical. The god serpent is called the one who dances in the shadows. It has to do with your energy and with your Kundalini power. According to African Origin of Biological Psychiatry by Dr. Richard King, the name for serpent exists in hieroglyphics where Kakais, Nkankes, synonymously interchanged with Nakad in the Egyptian hymn to Amun-Ra, the sun god is said to send his arrows against the serpent Naka or Nyoka. Nkos means king in many African dialects. In Niger, the word for serpent is Nyoka. The snake represents the sacred symbol for the rising of the Kundalini chakras, or power that is within you, or divine power that is within you, or divine spark that is within you. Ngola and Nyanban or Nyoke are the Swahili. In Wasuto, the word for serpent is Noga.
The NK and NG is the original sound according to Medunetta by Ra Unefa Amen on page 63 of his book. Nada, he says, nada undifferentiated energy, matter to give rise to the ninth manifestation. The ninth manifestation is known as the mother of all living things. Gerald Marcel, another very important Egyptologist here in our sense, maintained that the Y in the names is not a primary sound, but rather one that evolved from G. Naya or Naya in many North American native tribal dialects also means a serpent. Very interesting, very important. We were therefore kings, and we are descendants of kings and their queens. Do you know that Ethiopian kings were the driving force behind this creation of the Sanskrit writing system of India? In the sutras, Indo-Enogrites of India, languages of India, which are part of the Kushite branch of the African languages, the term Naga denotes original or first. In fact, in ancient India, the people that had the blackest and darkest skins were respected and held to the highest esteem, unlike today where the racist, colonialist, and alien concept of Varna or Varana or caste color racism places us, the Sudroids, Indo-Negroids, Black tribal Dalits, Negro Australoids, and many other blacks at the very bottom of the Indian society. We're giving a lot of reference here. From the Sudan, that's where you get Sudra, Central Africa, a black Indian caste. The word Naga means in the Vedic Sanskrit serpent. Now, we now know that the ancient Romans were the first people to corrupt the divine and royal noun Naga, a term they knew was used in Hamit and Nubia for royalty. The Romans colonized and spread the Latin language to Europe. They had a very strong reason to influence the Latin term Niga, which became Negre in French and Negro in Spanish. But why? It was because of our greatest queen that defeated and destroyed the Romans and stopped them from colonizing the whole of Africa. Amnirense Koreli Kidweli Ameniras Kore and Kandake. Kore and Kandake. The Roman Empire tried to expand south here, and they were destroyed at the first cataract, vanquished. And one thing happened that the Romans have never forgotten or forgiven us. Here is the thing that happened there, caused by one of the greatest rulers of Africa, Amenemhat. Kush died around 400 years later, leaving ruins that were largely unstarred until the 1900s. And then when they were digging out a temple they found in 1914, revealed to the shock of the archaeologist, the head of Augustus statue, the best preserved of its kind. We burned the Roman fort, destroyed them, defeated the Romans, and carried the bronze head of Roman Emperor Augustus to the Kushite city of Napata, a Nubian city, Napata. The Kwastu incense abena is from MRI Motel, one of the greatest researchers we have today. The oldest representation of the white crown hejet, symbol of royalty in Hamit, was found on an incense banner at Kwastu in Nubia. This one is the proof that the kingship of Hemet started in the south. This royal symbol can only be found in the areas located inside Africa and nowhere else. We wear that crown again in a way never done before. Straight talk. If we were kings and queens, what happens? And how can we restore ourselves to that level? First, we have to have the symbols of kings and the queens in our wardrobe. You need the kefresh, which is a blue crown, which you should wear daily. You wear it and then you put it back. You should also have a heka, the crosier, which is a symbol of the royal power. You should have also the nekeke, which is a scourge and a symbol for justice. Should also have the greatest of all that you should have. Worse, which is a scepter for gods. So these four, you should have them first. Buy these or make them for yourself and keep them in your wardrobe. And every day, just wear your kefresh for a few minutes and then walk around with your heka, as well as swing your nekek, as well as once in a while use your was. This is how you can restore yourself the level of a king as well as a queen. If you don't want to do it, it's all up to you. But we have shown you how you can absorb this power. Furthermore to these actions that we have spoken of, and the diet and many other things, and prayers and divinities and connecting with us and connecting to people of like mind, you have to restore your royal mind again. How do you do that? By focusing and getting yourself and others to rise above your amygdala withdrawal from reality and the reptile reaction brain logic, which is the training that the educational system, the media, and the political system in the world is doing on us. They are doing more and they are doing worse. You must practice free will identification of truth, self-confidence exercises, and positive affirmations to avoid the instinctive reactions to your life or to life under the guise of hypersexualization, gluttony, violence, escapism, and excuses and fear, which are personality disorders, traits that are put when your amygdala is not being used and you use a reptile brain against your free will, and you continuously implement programs and processes that destroys equality and truth. You can only do that and survive if you connect to groups and organizations and people that emphasizes these principles. This was reviewed by Marifado Academy, a scholar at Marifado Academy. We are very thankful for that. We are living as kings and queens already, some of us. Connect with us on Hamiti Blue Ethics Marifado KM on this email, jen@marifado.com. And this is our website, www.marifado.com. This preacher by LM Dumizulu saying, indeed, we are kings and queens, but the majority of us are in amnesia. Have a good day. Wake up, kings and queens. Thank you. Tatenda, siyabonga. Henkos, edupe.